Good afternoon, good morning, or good evening, depending on where you're joining us out there in the world. My name is Drew Altdoerffer, product manager here at Phase 1, and I wish I could say I was coming to you from beautiful, sunny Copenhagen, Denmark, but I can't. Winter's around the corner, it's cold, it's rainy, it's dark, and there's a lot more coming. But we're happy to be inside. So today what we're going to do is we're going to walk through the Phase 1 camera systems. I say systems because officially now we have two camera systems. And what I'd like to do today is really just introduce the modular camera system of the XF and the modular system of the XT and kind of how these two interact with one another, the pros and the cons of each, what one is really catered for and what the other is catered for. So this will be kind of a 30-minute rambling conversation about the XF, about the XT, and about our emphasis on modular design, and really what disciplines the XF is built for, and what disciplines the XT is built for. So, without further ado, let's get into it. This will be a very product-focused webinar because I am the product manager and these are my babies. So we're going to go into the modularity of the XF camera system first. And when I say modularity, everybody out there is familiar with a camera system where the lenses are interchangeable. That's of course nothing new to anybody out there, as well as perhaps maybe some accessories with your current camera system, be it a Canon, a Nikon, a Sony, even a Fuji. You have the ability to remove things like the viewfinder, put on, in our case, a waist level viewfinder, and then you have your very beautiful glass prism viewfinder. But our modularity extends much, much beyond just lenses and prisms, because we have centered at the heart of our ecosystem the digital back. Now, the digital back here is really just a component of any camera system. And at Phase 1, there are many digital backs. The digital back in this case is an IQ4. So the IQ4 is our latest generation of digital back. It features the Infinity platform. We have elements of Capture One built inside it. It is a very over-engineered digital back, in that it's not just meant to meet the needs of today, but this digital back is meant to meet the needs of 5, 6, 7 years from now. So this is a pretty hefty piece of computing power with a very large sensor. In this particular case, it's a 151 megapixel sensor. So that digital back is kind of the heart of the camera system, or the brains actually, because it's doing all the processing. It has the sensor in here, so it's doing all the capturing. Now the heart of the camera system could be argued to be in either the leaf shutter lenses or in the XF camera body, because we have a focal plane shutter. When you get over to another camera system like the XT, really only have one heart. We have one leaf shutter lens attached to the camera system, whereas here we have two shutter options. So if the digital back is the brains of the operation, it's doing all the heavy lifting when it comes to processing the image and outputting the image. So this is really going to be connected to your computer, your laptop, to your iPhone, to whatever device you want to connect this to offload your images. That's where the digital back comes into play in terms of connectivity. But the camera body itself is where we have a lot of computing power. So the XF camera system, which is compartmentalized into all these Schneider-Kreuznach lenses, the prisms, of which we have two, the XF camera system is its own computer, and this is a computer that's really controlling the sequence of capture. So it's controlling the lens, it's controlling the focal plane shutter, and it's really where you can put a lot of your customized options as a user. So if you want to refine your autofocus, if you want to shoot a time lapse, if you want to shoot a focus stack, if you want to have complete control over everything, this is really where the brain, or where the heart resides. Where the entire process of really making the camera system function is driven by this camera body. So that's one camera body, and this is a camera body that we've had around since 2015. It's a camera body that we continue to invest in, continue to refine, continue to grow. So from 2015 to now 2019, we've had the exact same camera body with many, many different firmware iterations that have opened up all sorts of different productivity and features and functionality when they're driving the digital back. Now, the XF camera system can drive the IQ1, IQ2, IQ3, and now the IQ4 digital backs. That really brings us back all the way to 2011, when the IQ systems came out. So 2011 to 2019, technology can all be driven by the XF. So that opens up a lot of options for us. When we talk about the modularity of the camera system, that's one aspect of what we mean by modularity, in that one camera body can really control all sorts of different technologies from 2011 all the way up to 2019 and well beyond 2019 where we are today. Modularity also means that different components can go on there. Here on the table I have five Schneider-Kreuznach Blue Ring lenses. These are the latest in the line of leaf shutter lenses that we provide. But this camera body itself is compatible with over 60 different lenses. We have the Schneider-Kreuznach Blue Ring lenses, we have the previous version of the Schneider-Kreuznach leaf shutter lenses, then we have Phase 1 lenses, which are focal plane lenses, we have the old legacy Mamiya lenses, we have Pentacon lens adapters that fit on here. You can put Hasselblad HB lenses onto the XF camera system, as well as, if I didn't already say it, all the legacy Mamiya lenses that are out there. So this camera system is quite a smart heart of the camera system in that it can integrate with many, many different devices. Now, that being said, this integrating with many devices is perfectly fine, but it's integrating with very specific devices. It's integrating with devices that are primarily made for studio use. All of the previous Mamiya cameras, even your Hasselblad Hasselblad V system is meant for studio use. Of course, you can use it out in the field, but the design of that camera system is for the studio. And that's really where this camera system is comfortable living, is within the studio. So this camera system married with this digital back or any of our IQ digital backs, with this prism and any of these lenses, is really going to be at home inside of a studio environment. It's certainly not the smallest camera body, it's certainly not the lightest camera body, and it is really a workhorse. So it's meant to be used in a studio environment where you can tether to your computer or your laptop, where you would have perhaps a digital tech, but a very controlled environment. Now that's not to say that this can't be used out in the field, and we see a lot of people do that, and we hope that a lot more people do. It absolutely can be used out in the field. It's fantastic out in the field, but of course, at its core, when it's designed and all the elements are evaluated, this is meant to be used in a studio, and then it can be taken elsewhere. Now, that modularity in a studio is really thinking about integrating with light sources, so Broncolor Pro Photo lights. This has a built-in Pro Photo Air. Integrating with studio equipment, so maybe a giant stand instead of a small tripod. It's really meant to be used in controlled lighting environments, so you're not going to be moving it around too much. You have the flexibility of a focal plane shutter, you have the flexibility of a leaf shutter. A leaf shutter can, of course, sync with any of the shutter speeds up to a 1/16th of a second, but then you have the focal plane shutter if you're shooting daylight in a studio, or you have some different lights where you can actually capture that, some hot lights instead of strobes, where you can utilize that high sync speed. So this has all the flexibility that you would expect in a controlled environment, which is fantastic for such a modular camera system, but it of course has its drawbacks. I'm a bit biased in terms of its drawbacks, so I ignore them for the most part, but to be honest about the camera system and why it has its big brother over here, we can talk a little bit about how this system compares to the XT and how these both work together to build a kind of perfect symbiotic system. So if that's our XF camera system, we can move on over here to the XT. Now, the XT, for anyone not familiar, is kind of a strange looking camera system. The XT camera body in and of itself is really just this frame right here. This is the entire camera body. It's not much to it. It's very thin. It's got a few different dials and buttons, but it doesn't have the complexity of the XF. There's no screen on the camera system. There's no battery to the camera system. It is a very simplified camera system. Now, that simplified camera system is really built to do a few things and do those few things very, very good. So primarily, this is meant to be used out in the field, typically in a landscape environment. You have some shift in the back, so you have 12 millimeters of shift in one direction, your Y direction, and 12 millimeters of shift, full extension, positive and negative, in your X direction. Now, why would you have that shift? Well, fixing perspectives, stitching for panoramic landscape photography. There's a lot of different uses for that shift movement, but the camera system can be very, very simple when we're really just relying on that application, landscape photography, perhaps a little bit of architectural in there. Those applications would really benefit from a very simple introduction. Now, if we're going to take the complexity of that shift, where precision is very, very important, and we're going to put that into something like the XF, well, this all of a sudden gets much, much bigger, much, much more complex, much, much more expensive. So to simplify the use case, to say when someone needs to have that shift movement in their camera system, when they need something that's smaller, lighter, then they can utilize the XT camera system. It removes a lot of the integration that we need for the XF. Now, neither is better or worse than the other, but they serve very different purposes. So the XT camera system really just has one button, and that is the shutter button. Now, when I mentioned in the beginning, this camera system has no dials and no buttons that really control what the camera system is doing. They have a physical dial to determine where the digital back is in relation to the lens circle, but they have no dials to control the camera. They don't have anything to interact with the IQ4 other than this button. Now, the XT camera system right now is supplied with three different lenses. We have a 23mm lens, we have a 32mm lens, and we have a 70mm lens. Now, those lenses that you can see here, they look a bit strange in that if this is our typical lens design. So if you're seeing these lenses for the first time and thinking that they look a bit strange, you can be forgiven because these lenses are, in fact, quite a bit strange looking. The lens that we're used to, the prototypical lens design, is just a cylinder, a barrel, with some glass on either end and some connecting points to the camera body. Now, these lenses look quite a bit different in that there is no typical barrel. The lens element on one side is quite small, or on the other side, the fitting is quite big. They have this giant tag sticking off the side, and that's actually where the shutter resides. So there's a lot of internal, external components that kind of hang off of these lenses that make them look, in all honesty, a bit odd. Now, they are a bit odd, but what they lack in their actual the beauty of their design or the elegance of their design, they certainly make up for in their precision and quality. These lenses have been around almost as long as phase one, but their film resolution equivalents have been around much, much longer. These lenses are purpose-built. Now, they're purpose-built by Rodenstock in Germany, and these lenses are of the highest quality lenses you can get, the most precise lenses you can get, but they come with quite a few drawbacks. One of the main drawbacks with this camera system, with these lenses, is that the manufacturer of these lenses does not manufacture a shutter. They only manufacture glass. Now, if you're Rodenstock and you're manufacturing glass and it's the only thing that you focus on, well, if you do one thing, you can do it to the nth degree. And they certainly do. So Rodenstock lenses are amongst some of the best in the world, and they're only rivaled by, of course, the German neighbor that makes the Schneider Kreuznach lenses, which we use on the XF. Now, when you make lenses for a camera system like the XF, you're gonna make them with a certain design criteria in mind. Now, mainly the design criteria that you're gonna have in mind is the size of the sensor in which you need to cover, whether or not there's gonna be any movement with the camera body, and then, of course, the distance from the lens to the digital back. So this is what's called the flange distance. So this is really the camera body's width is making up the distance between where the lens stops and where the film plane or the digital back sensor resides. So that distance is really a quality control decision when you're making these lenses. These lenses need to be able to accommodate for that flange distance. When you do that, there's going to be some benefits, there's going to be some drawbacks. So when we make lenses for the XF camera system, well, we can make them a little bit smaller for equivalent focal lengths. We can make them a little bit more compact. We can make them out of elements that are lighter, and we can integrate autofocus into those systems. When we make lenses for the XT camera system, or I should say when Rodenstock makes them, none of the design criteria comes to mind. Rodenstock doesn't need to worry about the shutter that's put on the lens. They don't need to worry about how it's mounted to the camera body. They don't really need to worry about what the flange distance is, because you, as a purchaser of the lenses, in this case phase one, purchasing the lenses from Rodenstock, we design the camera body, the shutter, how it's mounted, how it's integrated. So we make all of those decisions based on their glass. Now, as I said, there are differences between these camera systems. One of the quality trade-offs that we have to face with the XF is we're dealing with a flange distance. So that flange distance, which allows the mirror to move, is something that we have to factor into the design of the optics. When we have something like the XT camera system, our flange distance is almost it's almost non-existent. So because it's much, much smaller, we don't need to make any of the same concessions when designing a lens or choosing a lens that's designed for us. But now there's another set of problems that we have. That rear element of the lens is right up against the sensor. That lens element being so close to the sensor, all of a sudden we can have some diffraction, we can have some other issues that we need to be able to address with the technology in the IQ4. But what we can get is much crisper, much more contrasty, wide-angle optics. We can get sharper edge-to-edge. We can get less light fall-off. We can get less sharpness fall-off. So these are very attuned criteria that we get to choose from because we're using a camera system with no flange distance. So one of them has one set of drawbacks. A lot of the things that we can do with these lenses to make them quick, integrate them with autofocus, make them a little bit lighter, make them a little bit smaller, even though they're not that small, we can't do with these. We also really can't change the optical designs of these or improve it. We kind of have to work around what we have. But at the end of the day, what we get is two very different camera systems. We get the XF camera system and we get the XT camera system, which are purpose-built for really two different applications. Can I take the XF camera system out into the field and shoot landscapes and shoot architecture with the XF camera system? Absolutely, without a doubt. And it's a fantastic fit for that if that's your discipline. But you're going to be carrying around quite a bit of extra components that perhaps you don't need, a lot of extra technology that you're not going to apply to that given scene. Now, when I bring the XT out to those applications, landscape photography, architectural photography, I'm really using the camera system very efficiently. I'm using only the elements that I need, but if I want to take this camera system and move it into the studio, now all of a sudden there's a lot of things that I'm left wanting with on the XT camera system. Autofocus is of course one of them. There's no focal plane shutter. There's a lot of integration aspects of this camera system that don't exist here, but exist in the XF. So these are really purpose-built for anybody's application. If you're in a studio, or if you're in the studio, say, 70% of the time, and you go out into the field 30% of the time, the XF is a perfect fit for you. But if you're out in the field 80% of the time, maybe you go in the studio for still life photography 20% of the time, the XT might be a smarter choice. Or if you're doing both half-half, both systems are, of course, the best approach to meeting the needs of your client or your art, whatever that might be. Now, when I talk about both systems, I'm talking about the XF camera system and the XT camera system, but as we went over in the beginning, they're both modular, so really I just need to have one digital back. One IQ4 150 or 100 trichromatic or IQ3, whatever I need. I can use on equivalent systems to this, similar systems to this. But one digital back at the heart of your workflow, at the heart of your photography. One sensor, one known integration with Capture One software or whatever software you might use. I know what I'm going to get out of this sensor. I know how far I can push the files. The quality of the image is going to depend largely on the lens that I put in front of it. So if I have this one digital back, I have the IQ4 150. Well, I know that from that one digital back, that one sensor, I can get the exact same workflow no matter what I integrate into. And now I can choose if I need to use the XF for studio, let's say fashion photography, portrait photography. Well, I can use the XF and I know I'm going to get a fantastic image at the end of the day. I can take the exact same IQ4 and I can put it onto my XT camera system, go out in the field for landscape photography, for architectural photography, for really anything that requires that I have a smaller, lighter, technically advanced camera when it comes to movements of the system. Now all of a sudden I have a solution that's purpose-built for that. So when we talk about the XF camera system, we're talking about the studio applications of the XF camera system. We're talking about where this thing is really designed to go. And we said that in the very beginning, this is designed from day one, thinking of studio applications, and then how can we refine those studio applications to be used out in the field? And I think we do a pretty good job. We've got a lot of tools in here that are fantastic for landscape photographers, architectural photographers. But really, it starts from a design aspect of, this is meant for the studio, these are studio tools, now let's see if we can refine it to go out in the field. Whereas the XT, we get to approach with a completely different set of priorities. This is a field camera, without a doubt. It's meant to be used out in the field. You can handhold it, but of course I realize that it's not exactly small and nimble, but you know, it's designed from an ergonomic standpoint to work handheld. It's also designed so that it integrates very easily with a tripod. But it's meant to be used out in the field. And it's meant, all the tools that are in here, all the workflow aspects are meant to be used without connection to a laptop. Whereas the XF, on the other hand, all the tools that are in here are meant to be used either on the XF camera body or integrated into a laptop in the studio. So we have our studio camera, we have our field camera. We have the XF, we have the XT. Now, neither one is a better camera system than the other. These are just different camera systems. Anybody that's watching this, your specific workflow, your specific discipline will dictate which one of these camera systems is of course the better fit. For you landscape photographers that are watching, the XT camera system is really built for landscape photography. It's going to have everything you need and nothing you don't. If you're a studio photographer, well, the XF is really going to have everything that you need and nothing that you don't. But, of course, if you're doing one or the other, well, now you can make the decision of, am I mostly in the studio? I should maybe use this and just, you know, it's a little bit heavier to take out in the field. But maybe it's more than I need out in the field, but it'll still get the job done. Whereas the opposite approach, if I need this in the studio once or twice for still life, maybe even portrait if I'm patient, I can, of course, use it in that application. Now, having both systems, having both sets of lenses, having both camera bodies, it all comes back to that same digital back. So everything can come back to the same digital back with that same quality, with that same post-production workflow that I need and I'm comfortable with, that gives me the efficiency that I want to apply to any of these camera systems. So the modularity of our camera systems, of course, being a phase one webinar, is going to focus primarily on our two camera systems, the XF camera system, which has a main focus in the studio, but a lot of applications outside the studio. And then our XT field camera, which is primarily something to be used out in the field, nimble, small, lighter, limited, certainly in a lot of the automation that the XF can do, but it gives you the control at your fingertips for what it is we would hope you're using it for. So when we talk about modularity of the Phase 1 camera systems, it's really these two that we're talking about. However, there are other options when we talk about modularity, and that's really the camera systems that perhaps you've seen, but it's these beauties. This is a Cambo camera system, the WRC400. We've done a webinar well in the past about the open platform philosophy of Phase 1. Which is a very important philosophy of Phase 1, and that is we want to make sure that we can integrate into other camera systems, other than the XF, other than the XT. Now, we think that we can meet the needs of every single full-frame, medium-format, hopeful customer with the XF and the XT, or the XF or the XT. But of course, there's always going to be people out there that are looking for something which we can't offer. So it's very important for us from a philosophical standpoint that we, as a responsible company, can integrate into camera systems like this. So you can see a lot of similarities in the WRC that you can with the XT, and that's because they are really from the same birthplace. This is a highly technical camera system from Cambo. It has the same kind of movements that you would find on the XT, but it has very old Copal shutter technology. It has a lot of, you know, if you're ever looking at video cameras and videographers, you know, all these access points to bolt different accessories on there for specialty purposes. A lot of the camera systems that are like this, that have existed for a very long time, kind of have the same design aspect to it. It's a very utilitarian design. It's more than you would need. It's a very busy, very steep learning curve in terms of using these things. But they are beautiful camera systems when you get to use them, but they are built for very specific purposes. The XT, on the other hand, having been born from this kind of aspect with our open platform philosophy and modular design at the center of it, the XT is where we can take some of the disciplines that thrive with these other camera systems and refine that workflow, update that workflow for 2019 technology, and really make sure that it's an enjoyable experience, that it's a simpler experience, and that we can use that integration to focus on things like image quality, as opposed to worrying about Copal shutter availability or integration aspects of a technical nature. So those are the two camera systems in general, the XF camera system and the XT camera system, as well as a little bit of background on our modularity and open platform philosophy. So when we talk about the workflow of the two camera systems, and I keep going back to everything going through that same digital back, that same IQ4, and giving you the same workflow, what I'm really talking about is your workflow in Capture One software, or of course your capturing workflow. Because these are essentially two camera systems, but they're made from the same company and they're all based on the exact same brains of the IQ4, your functionality is going to be largely the same. So we do have the Profoto integration when it comes to the XF. So what that means, of course, if you're a professional and you're using the XF camera system, your integration is not going to just be to a speed light like this. It's going to be with an actual pack in your studio. But just to demonstrate, you know, wirelessly, we have integration and control from the XF to your Profoto pack. So that's just one aspect of a professional workflow where the camera system, the results, the control, everything is going to be the exact same when you're using this camera system with your Profoto in the studio. It's a professional application, gives you control through the camera system that's consistent with control that you would find in Profoto accessories, so that you have this consistency of your workflow. You have a very highly attuned professional workflow. Now, this camera system is built, of course, to tether. So tether to something like your laptop. And it can tether multiple ways. It can tether wirelessly over Wi-Fi. There's an Ethernet port, or quite simply, you can plug in your USB cable, and now you can tether from the XF to your computer. So that tethered ability is a huge part of that professional workflow that Phase 1 gives you with the XF camera system and the IQ4. But that tethered workflow, of course, doesn't, it's not restricted to just the XF because it follows the IQ4. So that same professional workflow tethered for one reason in a studio, that reason would be typically you're going to have a digital tech running the machine, editing as images come in. The photographer, you, is going to be shooting very quickly, shooting the model. Images are going to be coming in over Ethernet, Wi-Fi, or USB-C. They're going to be edited as fast as they can be. The client is going to be there to approve them on an ongoing basis. I mean, that's your typical professional studio workflow. But if you are perhaps something not as fast-paced, it's a slow still life photographic application, tethered workflows are still going to be very important because you're going to need to see that image on something other than the screen of your digital back. So having that tethered workflow, having that there instantly, very fast, very efficient, having the quality move through exactly as you would expect is incredibly important. But when we get into field applications, tethering the XF, for example, we can do the exact same thing. If we're out in the field, we can either use our laptop to tether, or as I always do, I have a Surface tablet with me, and this is what I tether with. So this is my mobile tethering workstation. I have the XT with a simple cable running over to my my Microsoft Surface Pro. But sometimes a cable isn't long enough, right? This is the length of the actual USB-C cable. This isn't going to give me the distance that I want from my camera to my computer, so I can always use Wi-Fi. So having the exact same tethered experience, albeit with Wi-Fi a little bit slower, but I still have complete control from my Microsoft Surface tablet to my XT camera system, no matter where it is. The only thing that I lack is autofocus control. When it comes to the same application, this tablet to my XF, the workflow stays the exact same because I'm using the IQ4. So keep that in mind that when I say tethered workflow, I'm tethering to the IQ4. I'm not necessarily tethering to the XT or the XF. I'll have control to both of those camera systems, but I'm tethering to the IQ4. So I have a professional application with the XF in a studio integrating into my Profoto lights. I have all the flexibility that I would need in a studio for tethering. Ethernet, USB-C, or even Wi-Fi, I have all the control that I would expect from this professional camera system. And then I can take that exact same workflow, that exact same approach to capturing, and I can bring it out in the field with something a bit smaller, a bit more nimble on the X-T camera system. So then we can talk about just the basics of my workflow and integration. When I'm in a studio, I'm probably gonna have a big studio stand that I'm using, but I might have a tripod. Now the XF camera system is of course very compatible with tripods with L brackets, but it is just a standard handheld camera system. It's meant to be used with two hands in the studio, autofocus and fire, but of course I can put it onto a tripod. I can control the focus from Capture One. I can use tools like the focus stack tool on the XF to really integrate into that sturdy tripod use. The XT, on the other hand, taking the same IQ4 from XF to XT, is built with a just an Arca type tripod foot, so that I can very easily just pop this onto a tripod out in the field. So this camera system is built to be used on a tripod. That's why that tripod foot is integrated into the camera system. So there's no fuss, there's no screws that can come loose, there's no adapters that I need to put on there. That tripod foot, which rotates from one side to the other, is integrated to the camera system so that I can absolutely quickly put this onto a tripod and go ahead and shoot. That tripod workflow is a huge part of what this camera system is built for. Landscape photography, architectural photography. So having that aspect there built into the camera, designed into the camera, is incredibly important. But that's the workflow focus of this camera system. We know that it's mostly going to be used on a tripod. If you want to use it handheld, you're welcome to. If you want to take off this tripod mount, you're welcome to. But we know that primarily it's going to be used on a tripod, so integrating that tripod foot, that Arca tripod foot, so that it's quickly at your fingertips, being able to rotate the camera system is incredibly important. That's all an aspect of that workflow with the X-T camera system over the XF camera system. Then there's other aspects of your actual workflow once you are using the camera systems respectively. So I can give you a little bit of an overview of that quickly. Do as I say, not as I do. Treat your camera systems with respect. When you put an IQ4 onto an XF camera body, it loads into an XF camera mode. So not only is the workflow in terms of tethering and control consistent between this and any other camera system, but it gives you access to the XF from the rear screen. So you can make changes and controls from the IQ4 that would typically exist here on the XF camera body. Now, that exact same IQ4, taking it off of the XF and putting it onto the XT, loads a completely different menu, but all the essentials remain. So I still have my shutter speed and aperture, which is controlling the X shutter here, but I have some other information and I've done away with a lot of the clutter of things that I'm not gonna need from the XF. So again, it maintains consistency in my workflow in that I'm still controlling shutter speed, aperture, live view, shutter actuation, all the other things that I need stay in the exact same spot. But the system's intelligent enough to know that when I'm on an XF, I go into the XF mode and I give you access to all the XF controls. When I'm on an XT, I go into the XT mode and I give you access to all the XT controls. And those are gonna change depending on your discipline. So if you're using the XF camera system, you're gonna need access to things like your autofocus. You're gonna need different tools when you're in live view. When you're on the X-T camera system, autofocus isn't an option, but you're gonna need to know your positioning, your X and Y positioning from these shifts. And you're gonna need to know different things in live view, get access to different tools, capture from live view, in case you can't reach the capture button because the camera's in a strange position. All of these things are gonna be a little bit different on the X-T camera system than they are on the XF because the workflow that this is intended for out in the field, landscape or architecture, is going to change slightly. So that's part of the benefit of having both systems, is that the IQ4 digital back itself is gonna be intelligent and adapt kind of your workflow needs. On the XF, it's going to be one beast. On the XT, it's going to be another. But at the heart, both are very, very similar. Similar in the fact that they're going to be intuitive. What you expect to be in one place on the XF is going to carry over to the XT and vice versa. But really, at the end of the day, your workflow, the benefits of your workflow, the tools that are available in each, the optical quality that's available with the XT, the optical quality and diversity that's available with the XF, all of these things together, all the different tools and components, are going to benefit your workflow in many, many different ways so that it can be as efficient and as high quality as possible. But high quality is what it's all about at the end of the day. And that high quality in terms of image quality is what the IQ4 provides you. So we always like to joke around at phase one when we're talking about products. Our priority is always image quality, image quality, and image quality. It's the first, second, and third priority for everything that we do. And that comes with some sacrifices, certainly. Sometimes we have to make a camera system that's rather big and rather heavy. Sometimes we have to make a camera system that's rather simple and doesn't have all the fantastic new gizmos and doodads that one would like to have. Because we have to focus on image quality. We have to focus on precision. We have to focus on the control of the camera system to make sure that your photography, at the end of the day, is exactly what all of us want. That the photography is what stands apart, not your use of the camera system, but your photography. And that photography, that image quality, is what the IQ4 delivers. The best possible image quality is what this camera system, everything encapsulated in here, and that sensor can provide. As long as they're paired up with the right lens and the right technique and the right user, this is going to give you the best image quality at the end of the day. And that image quality is going to be equivalent if you're on the XF or you're on the XT camera system. That image quality is going to be the best possible image quality. You're going to have the best possible workflow in Capture One. You're going to have complete dynamic flexibility with those files from the IQ4 so that this will give you everything that it is you could possibly want. And because you have one digital back that works on two different camera systems that provides you access to all these different tools, all these different components, all these different workflow aspects, you really have the best of the best of the best in terms of photographic tools that will give you the best of the best in terms of your final photographic presentation. So that's what these two camera systems give you. At the heart of it is the IQ4 with the fantastic sensor and system that drives it. And then, of course, there's always Capture One that's there to edit your images and really bring out everything that you know you wanted and know you saw at the moment of capture. And that workflow aspect stays consistent whether you're using the XF or the XT. There's benefits and drawbacks to each, but if you have both, then you have the best of both worlds. So, thank you for joining us on today's webinar. I hope you learned something from me. I realize that this was a very one-sided conversation, so if you're ever in need of more information about the Phase 1 camera systems, please reach out to our fantastic Phase 1 partner network. They're always out there to provide a demo of the camera system, and they're also running quite a few events these days. The fall colors are out and people are traveling, so get out there in the field with one of our partners. They have Phase 1 camera systems available for you to use, get some hands-on experience, and ask somebody that knows these things inside and out. There's also quite a few events that we have posted on our website and some of our partners' websites that we'd be happy to see you at. I say we'd be happy to see you at those because it's the feedback from customers like you at those events to people like me if I'm traveling, or Lau, our chief visionary officer, or any other Phase 1 employee that really drives us to push the envelopes and deliver the camera systems that we know our customers want. So I hope I see you out there, and if not meeting up with me, I hope you reach out to one of our partners to book a demo or get some hands-on experience with a Phase 1 camera system. Until next time, take it easy.